Good afternoon, everybody. Professor Ravi Narayankar, Principal, Shambhal College, Professor Kosha Tiwari, Coordinator, IQAC, Dr. Vinod Nehra, TIC, Commerce Department, Dr. Mukhtar Rohtagi, Convener, and Mr. Varun, Senior, the Session Coordinator. And thank you very much, all students, for inviting me on this very, very special session on contemporary issue in business. This is, I can understand, like in our own college also, we have a society, we call it COMSOG. I can see your society, the Commerce Association, COMBLAS, in association with IQAC. And you have been, you know, organizing this student development program. And you have been talking about contemporary issue in business and management. So first of all, let me congratulate you, all of you, for organizing such an event and taking initiative, especially for student. It's not an easy job to organize such kind of program, and patiently listening these kind of resource person on different issues. We all attend classes, we all do different kind of project, we submit different kind of assignment. But when we have this kind of student development program, it gave you another perspective, which is bit away from your textbook. Because you read textbook, you submit your assignment, for what? One thing is very clear, that is one objective, to secure good grade, good marks. It's not in your college, in all colleges of Delhi University or schools also. Student has one objective, to secure good grade, good marks, because your marks represent that you are highly intelligent. And up to some extent, it's a true, but now things has changed. Now we are moving away from that old system, traditional system, where we all were running, we all were competing to get or secure good grade, good marks. But besides securing good grade, good marks, what we need to do, we need to learn skills. And this kind of student development program, they really, really give you some kind of understanding. They give you some kind of chance to understand that how things has changed over the period of time. What are the new things? What are the new issues which you need to learn? Because when you will be starting your own venture or when you will be going for some kind of job, they will not ask you what you read in your financial accounting, what you read in your taxation, what did you read in your commerce or marketing or business studies. They will talk about the application of that. So this student development program gave us some kind of understanding that yes, these are the application of whatever we have learned in the classroom. So let me congratulate you all for organizing such a program. And you all have taken this nice initiative, especially to Shamlal College team member, thank you, faculty member, thank you very much for taking pain with the association, Commerce Association, to think about this kind of program. And you have been running this kind of program successfully in past also. I have been a part of different programs, I remember, and especially during COVID when everything is online. I can see you are still very, very active, very, very active. So I don't see many colleges, they have been taking this kind of initiative to, you know, impart skills. And this is a one platform where, I mean, especially through your college, we are able to connect with the student and we are able to share our experience, our learning with our students. So once again, thank you very much and welcome to this very, very special session on student development program. And I thought, when I received a call from Varun sir, what should I teach? What should I discuss? So when you think of marketing, what comes in your mind? Simple things, 4 P's for product, 7 P's for services. Now, these 4 P's, 7 P's have been there for more than 20, 25, 30 years. And we always talk about these 4 P's, 7 P's. And it's a something which is conceptual understanding of marketing, which is conceptual understanding of marketing. Now, just think of introduction of internet, introduction of social media, introduction of digital media, digital marketing, social marketing. Now things has changed. Now there is no dearth of opportunities, there is no dearth of products, there are no dearth of services. There is a huge, huge competition. I remember in 1982 when we wanted two-wheeler. So at that time, LML Vespa, they introduced LML Vespa. Vespa basically, they introduced LML Vespa. And what happened at that time, there was shortage of supply. So what they did, they invited application, and with application they invited money also, 500 rupees. And they promised that it will take them 5 years to deliver a product. Now think in 1982 and today, when you think of not a two-wheeler, you think of four-wheeler, you think of any product. You don't have, you know, limitation. You can access anywhere now. You can access anything on this earth through, you know, digital marketing or internet. So that is the beauty. Now things has changed. That those fees were applicable at that time in 1982, 92, 2002, 2012 also. I'm not sure about those fees, four fees or seven fees in 2020, because things has changed. When you think of any product, what comes in your mind? It's that you would like to physically visit some place and buy that product? No at all. If you want to know anything about that product, you always Google. You search on a Google and find out that what kind of product, what kind of services, what kind of options are available. Unlimited options are there. And let me tell you frankly, whenever I am on Facebook, I see new products. Right? It's not so highly branded product, but these are new products available on Facebook. And they serve us, they serve such kind of need which no one else can serve, right? There are so many products which are according to your need, which are according to your personality, and they fulfill that need. And this comes not through a particular channel which is a traditional channel. It is a emerging channel that you see that product, see the option, see the price range, see the color, everything you can see. Click, pay money, and the products would be, things would be available at your doorstep. So now my question to all of you, before we move further, let me ask my question after this video. Let me show you one video. How should I show you that video? Okay, just give me 1 minute. I hope I would be able to show you that video. Yeah. Yes. Where is that video? Okay, I believe that should be here. Let me make it big, and I hope you might have seen this boy talking to younger one and complaining, and he's complaining about what? Let me run for you. I hope you all are with me. Say yes in your chat box. Let me see how many of you are here with me. I can see 55 participants right now. Say yes in your chat box. Let me see. Let you all. Okay. Rajni, say yes. Khushi, Mayank. Okay. Kushbu, Priya. Very good. Divyanshi. Okay, great. So you all are with me and you are able to see my screen here, everybody. And let me run this video for all of you. So I don't know whether you are able to hear this video. Are you able to listen this video or not? But I hope you might have seen this video somewhere in some program, maybe on, especially on television. And let me run.
सबके सामने मुझे भाव ही नहीं देता है और जब कोई नहीं होता तब
So it says that it looks like a cake, but it's a Cadbury. And you can see the boy, big boy, complaining the younger one that you are like this cake, right? whenever mother is around, you don't look at me. But whenever mother is not here, you pay attention to me. Right? And you are very naughty, you are like this Cadbury. So let me ask you, here they are not actually talking about the basic product. What is basic product? You all aware of, that is the chocolate, right? So instead of talking about chocolate, they are talking about Cadbury. They are talking about, I don't know, they are representing some kind of relationship between the younger and the elder one. So how do you see this advertisement? Are they really talking about chocolate, or they have been reflecting on something else? Like one thing I mentioned, it's a kind of relationship. So let me see your reflection, everybody. For you, what is Cadbury here? Put your remark. Okay, Rajni say it's relationship and ignorance. Great. Go ahead, everybody. And in general, what is chocolate for you? Chocolate is just a product, or let it be a Cadbury? What is Cadbury chocolate for you, everybody? Or maybe you can reflect on this particular advertisement. Yeah, let me see everybody your reflection. I can see all of you all. Okay, so okay, great. Rajni say it's chocolate is happiness. So chocolate is Cadbury. Here we discuss chocolate. Here Cadbury is relationship, and Rajni say it's a happiness. Great. So let me see some more reflection, everybody. Go ahead please, everybody, and put your remarks. What is this Cadbury for you? Go ahead, everybody, please do it quickly. We don't have much time. I know you all are with me. Bhavika, Chirag, Vaishnavi, Sohar, Patra, please put your remarks in your chat box, everybody. I can see your chat box. Simple Aurora, please put your remarks in your chat box. Let me see. How do you see this Cadbury here? Because Rajni Singh say it's a relationship, it's an ignorance, it's a chocolate, it's happiness. What about others? Okay, I can see one more. Sign of love between brothers. Very good. Okay, so it's a happiness, it's a love, it's a relationship. Okay, go ahead, everybody. Go ahead, let me see your reflection. I can see of more than 50 participants right now. Everybody need to reply. In general, you can reply that, okay. So Parth Sehgal say it's depicting a pack of happiness and sweetness. Okay. And that happiness and sweetness in relationship, I believe. Am I right, Parth? Okay, so everybody, I hope the way I'm talking to you, you are comfortable with English, you are comfortable the way I'm talking to you. If you want, I can speak in Hindi also. But, okay, go ahead, everybody. I hope the concept I want to convey to all of you, you all agree. And okay, just we say it's a strategy of marketing, that's fine, but in general it's from a company side. For a customer, as a customer, how do you see this Cadbury or a chocolate? Okay, Bhavika say chocolates are here represent joy. Okay, great. So now you can see so many synonyms of chocolate or instead of chocolate at Cadbury. So it's a joy, it's a relationship, beautiful relationship, it's love, it's a happiness. So now with whatever advertisement you see, whatever product you see on television, instead of talking about that basic product, they reflect on what? Happiness. They reflect on what? Relationship, right? So love, hate. So whatever advertisement nowadays, whatever product strategy you see, whatever advertisement nowadays you see, each and every product, each and every advertisement, they convey some message. And here, message is what? It's a relationship between brother, right? Let me see some more example. Go ahead, everybody. Let me see your reflection. I can see all of you. I need two more reply, two more reflection from your side, which will really make me feel that you all are with me. Yeah, go ahead, everybody. Don't hesitate. I mean, you can write just a one word, I don't mind. But reflect on, it will really motivate me, inspire me that yes, you all are here with me. And together we are learning something. Go ahead, everybody. Let me see your reflection. Go ahead. After Bhavika, I didn't see any reply. Go ahead, everybody, and write something in your chat box. I can see a lot of approximately 50 participants right now. Priya, please write something. Aryan, please write something in your chat box and reflect on what is chocolate for you. Go ahead, everybody. Please reply, everybody, then we'll proceed further. Okay, so we have three or four reply. It's all about happiness, it's all about relationship. So okay, it's a kind of sweetness in relationship. Thank you, Daksh. It is sweet for us. Okay, great. Okay, great. So Hard has mentioned that it's a sugar carbon. Okay. So whenever you see this kind of relationship, whenever you see this kind of product, let me take another example. What about how about CCD? You know the CCD, Cafe Coffee Day. When you think of Cafe Coffee Day, is it just a coffee which comes in your mind, or when you think of CCD, what comes in your mind? Let me see. Now everybody needs to reply. What is CCD for you? Is it just a coffee shop for you? Because coffee you can have in your canteen, which will cost you 10 to 20 rupees, or maybe nearby any corner it will cost you 10 to 20 rupees. But you're ready to pay 150 rupees when you go to CCD. So you are paying 150 rupees just for that cup of coffee, or when you come to CCD, it's more than a cup of coffee. And when you think of CCD, what they tell you? They tell you that they are selling coffee. Or what is the punchline of CCD? Okay, so Suhart say that when you think of coffee, it's an aroma. Okay, it's a meetup place. Thank you, Akanksha Dikshit. So when you want to talk, when you want to meet someone, it's you need a place where you can sit, you can chat, you can discuss. So it's a more than a product which we call coffee. So more than that, the kind of place, the kind of relief, the kind of peace, as Rajni Singh has mentioned, they offer you more than a coffee. And here in this relationship of Cadbury, it's a more than a chocolate. So where, as a customer, are you really, really looking for a particular product, or you are looking for happiness, relationship, love, hate? So these are different phenomena we are looking for, because we all are social animal. So more than a product, we want that it should represent something. It should represent some kind of phenomena, right? So let me move further. So I hope now things are clear to all of you what we have been talking about. And let me come back to my PPT. And here is my PPT, you all can see. So we start with, we have already discussed one video and two example of Cadbury chocolate and CCD. And what is CCD for you? What is Cadbury chocolate for you? Already have reflected through your chat box that it's more than a cup of coffee, it's a more than a chocolate, it's something which give you happiness, it give you relief, it give you some kind of feeling that you feel happy, right? So there have been so many phenomena, there have been so many things which they offer you. So here, just think of marketing. When we think of marketing, who comes into your mind? The father of marketing, Philip Kotler. And Philip Kotler has mentioned in his books that marketing is all about finding needs and try to make a product so that you can fill out that need and create that need, satisfy the customer at profit. So this is a simple definition which has been there for more than 30-40 years. Now it's a time to think about this marketing concept, to talk about this marketing concept. So here you can see marketing is telling people why you have what they need. Very, very simple thing, very simple thing. So here it means you need to tell people, hey, this particular service, this particular goods, this particular solution, this particular idea, this particular service, I can offer for you, right? And that which you need. And very, very important, you can see in this line, and listening to what they care about. So they care about what? Here, the elder brother care about the younger brother. Mother care about children. So that they were looking for mineral water, right? For their health, they want their safety, health, good health. So that you want what? Bonvita, that they should drink Bonvita. So it's all about care. It's all about relationship. And it's all about listening to what they care about. So you care about what? You care about your health during COVID-19. So what you need to buy? You need to buy all those products which boost your immunity. So here, it's a communication. It's a listening to what they care about. So we care about our children. Teacher care about student. Student care about parents. So this is what we have been into a kind of relationship. So as a marketing company, as a marketer, we need to understand what people care about, who you care about, right? So what kind of relationship you are in. So here, this is very, very important thing you can see here. I remember one of my student, he passed out from our college. Now he joined one company, E&Y, and after 6 months, he quit that job because he felt that it's a simple routine work. Every day I come to my office, have similar kind of job, similar kind of work. So I'm not interested in this. And he was staying in Gurgaon. So there he saw that in Gurgaon and these kind of places like Noida, Bangalore, Hyderabad, where a lot of young people come for jobs, right? And many people come for study also, higher study. What they need? So he was listening what they were looking for, what they were caring for. So these young people, those who come to Noida or maybe Gurgaon or Hyderabad, Bangalore, Pune, these kind of city, they are looking for house on rent, right? So there have been lot of organization, those who are serving young people, and they provide them houses on rent. Similarly, in Delhi University, those who come to study for Delhi University for an undergraduate program or master program, colleges, they don't have sufficient accommodation, especially in terms of hostel. So where these students supposed to go? So they are looking for PG, they are looking for hostel nearby the colleges, especially in North Campus. So who is going to tell them that this kind of charges, this kind of amenity, this kind of hostel, this kind of food, everything is available not far away from the colleges. So who and we are listening that student, they have this kind of need. So as a marketer, what we need to do, we need to listen that, okay, so this my student who was in Gurgaon, he saw that lot of young people, they come for a job, they look for house on rent, but beside that they are looking for furniture. Now, furniture, you need to buy. And these young people, those who come here for jobs, they have one problem that they 6 months they work here in Gurgaon. Next 6 months they move to some other place like maybe Bangalore or Hyderabad. And it's a very difficult task. It's a big, big pain for them to carry this furniture from one place to another place. So he saw this and he was listening. He was listening that they care about their furniture, right? They want good furniture. Money is not a concern, money is not a problem, but they cannot carry it from one place to another place whenever they are supposed to move. So he decided to provide furniture on rent. That was a new idea 5 years ago. And I remember 2 years ago, I wanted to invite him to my college for delivering a lecture. So I requested him, would you like to come? He said, sir, I'm in USA. So I said, what are you doing in USA? He said, I'm carrying forward my business of providing furniture or rent in USA market also. So this is what you need to listen, what you are looking for, what you want, and tell them that, hey, we have this kind of services, we have this kind of unique solution, we have this kind of things for you. So, and I can give you another example also, IKEA. IKEA is a big company, and today I was listening to my student presentation and she said IKEA Sweden company. So I said it's a Sweden company. It was a Sweden company, but now it's no more a Sweden, it's an American company. And the company had been serving USA and different market around the world, and they have launched their business in India also, I remember 2 years back. And they started from Hyderabad, and you wouldn't believe, first day there were approximately 40,000 people that turned up and they wanted to see IKEA showroom. So that was crazy. I mean, that kind of craze Indian showed when this company, they launched their showroom in Hyderabad. Now another showroom they have launched in Mumbai, I think near Pune also. So what is IKEA? IKEA is basically, they have been providing a number of products, furniture products. And the problem was with IKEA in USA, when they launched their product in the USA, was that in USA people like big kind of stuff, big kind of couch, furniture, bed. And when it's a big, it's very difficult to carry it from showroom, from workshop to your home. How to carry big stuff? And frequently people in USA, they move from one place to another place very frequently, because they switch over their jobs very frequently. So they move from LA, Los Angeles to New York very frequently, or some other places also. It's very difficult for them to carry that big you know, couch, big sofa set or big bed. So IKEA came with an idea that we should make big furniture. We should not compromise with that, because people like big furniture, but it should be packed in, when we want to carry it, it should be, you know, it should have such kind of screw and bolt that you can unfold it and you can fold it. So whenever you want to use it, unfold it. When you want to, you don't want to use it, you want to carry it to other place, just fold it, unscrew it, you know, right, and bring it together. And that you can pack in one, you know, what you call simple packaging or flat packaging. And who carry this flat packaging? It's not IKEA themselves, but FedEx. FedEx, I hope you heard of FedEx, a big organization. It's a big courier company. So Mr. FedEx, it was the story of Mr. Fed also in 1970. I don't know if I should tell you that story or not, but let me, I will tell you that story later on. So here we are talking about that we are listening what you are looking for, and then we are telling you that, okay, you have this need, we have this solution for you, right? Let me see if you are all with me. Say yes in your chat box. Go ahead, everybody. I can see it's already 40 minutes. We have been discussing one very simple marketing concept for last 40 minutes. Okay, great. I can see Ria. Okay, I can see Bhavika, Vaishnavi, Aniket. Great. Go ahead, everybody. I know that a lot of people, they join this and they disappear after that. So let me see if you all are with me. Khushi Jain, Shohat, okay. Aniket is there. Go ahead, everybody. I can see more than 55 participants right now. Sumit, thank you very much. Let me see. Oh, great. Daksh is there. Go ahead, everybody. Surat, Rawat. Go ahead, everybody. You all are listening. Thank you very much for your patience. Mansi Bhatnagar is there. Great. Okay, great going on. Okay, Arudra, okay, Mansi, Pooja, okay, Chetan Kumar, thank you everybody. So I think things are clear to all of you, what we have been discussing. What message I want to convey now that it's more than a marketing, which is there for more than 30-40 years as a concept, as a phenomena. Now a little bit changes has occurred for more than 10 years because things has changed because of internet, because of digital marketing, and because of Google and the internet, and because of social media marketing too. Right, let me move further now. I hope this is clear that what is marketing for all of us with one or two examples. Please note down, I will discuss with you FedEx. If I forget, please you can remind me. Okay, this Cadbury chocolate we already have discussed, Meeta Chupa Rustam. And I hope with this example things are clear. It's not only sweet, something sweet you gonna give to someone. It's more than a sweet, it's a kind of relationship. It's a kind of happiness, it's a kind of beauty, it's a kind of, you know, love, hate. So many things are there which describe our culture, which describe human being, which describe people, which describe a relationship. I hope now you understand what I'm talking about. A very, very simple thing, you all have studied principles of marketing. I'm not going to talk about what is mentioned in textbook, what is principles of marketing. But here, what we need to do as a marketer, we need to always listen what's going on around. What we need to do, you always keep on, you know, open your ear, eyes, and see what is changing, what is going on. If you can't, you know, move further, it would be very difficult for you to understand what is going on. It would be very difficult for you to compete. If you want to compete, you need to keep on listening that, okay, these things are, you know, emerging. People have started liking this. They have started disliking this particular thing. So that is the need of the hour. I hope you know, we used to have what you call tape recorder, right? And then in 2000, I remember in 1995 or 2000, Walkman came. So see, from, you know, tape recorder to Walkman, then CD player. I mean, all these things have disappeared because new technology came, because people, they wanted something new. They don't want to continue with the old traditional obsolete product. They want something new. Maybe in terms of product, maybe in terms of services, maybe in terms of price, maybe in terms of look. So we need to keep on inventing. We need to keep on listening what you are looking for. As I had given one example of my father, that in 1982, we wanted a two-wheeler. And at that time, the waiting period was 5 years. Now just think of current scenario. You want a bike, you want a four-wheeler, whatever you want. You want immediately, you want quick, that it should be available right now. And what you're looking for, that my car bonnet color should be like this. It should have this kind of shape. It should have this kind of speed. It should have this kind of design. And believe me, time is not far away when, according to your demand, company would be designing your car. That will come soon, I believe. So that much customization, that kind of technology, that kind of services has occurred. So as a marketer, what we need to do, we need to always keep on listening. What is going on around? This is the first principle. I remember we used to have one company, Coca-Cola, just one company, Coca-Cola, long time back in USA. And they thought that nobody can beat them. I mean, this is some kind of understanding. When you are a big company, you always have misunderstanding, you have misfeeling that yes, we are the biggest company, no one in the world can beat us. Believe me, you never know. For example, HMT, a watch company, a Chandigarh based watch company, and it used to be a number one company in 1960, 1970, 1980, 1990. And after 19, this company disappeared. If you don't know HMT, ask your parents and they will tell you. I mean, it was like a Tata watch company, Titan. So HMT was Hindustan Machine Tool Limited Company, was number one in India, and they were supplying, they were making watch, wrist watch. And unfortunately, what happened, they were not able to understand what kind of trend, what kind of things will emerge. So they were not listening. Whatever they have had, they thought we are number one, no one can beat us. So they were continuing with the same old traditional technology, old traditional design, product, goods, but it will not continue, believe me. It will not remain same. So you need to come out with some new design. You need to come out with some new feature. It could be anything. It could be anything. You need to find out some solution, right? And I hope because of Facebook, because of social media, because of YouTube, a lot of things has emerged. And I know that you all are very, very efficient, very, very effective. You all are very good listener. You all are very good learner. And you all have that kind of passion. You all have that kind of creativity. You all have that kind of learning that you can bring change. And you're looking for a change because you want to always feel that I should be different from other. So when you come to college, when you come to classroom, you won't like to look like that you are different from other classmate. And for that, what you do? So you always, you know, bring something which can help you to look different. Maybe in the way you talk, the way you walk, the way you, you know, wear clothes, and something you want that you should look different. So it's a time that you need to listen what's going on around as a marketer and find out that, okay, what kind of changes we can bring in our product. So I was giving example of Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola was the one company, and at that time it was a one soda company and a soft drink company, we call it in India. And they thought that we are the biggest company, no one can beat us. And at that time there was a small company, very small company, Pepsi. So Pepsi was selling 5 bottle in a day. On the other hand, Coca-Cola was selling 5 lakh bottle in a day. Can you think of the difference between Pepsi and Coca-Cola? Right? So you never know what kind of challenge you have to face. So one person who was from Shyamlal College, he was working at that time, who was among from you, right? He was a student like you. And he was working in at Pepsi. Pepsi was a very small company, had 5 or 6 bottle they were selling every day. On the other hand, Coca-Cola was selling 5 lakh bottle every day. So the boy who was from Shyamlal College in Pepsi, he wanted to prove it. He wanted to see, he wanted to check the whether the taste of Pepsi or the taste of Coca-Cola people like. So what he did, he made a survey. So he made a survey in a mall, and he didn't disclose which is Pepsi, which is Coca-Cola, and asked people that you can taste it free of cost and let me know which taste you like the most. So 80% people, day one, they like taste of Pepsi than Coca-Cola. So 85% people like the taste of Pepsi. Can you believe it? So they, he keep on, you know, working on this kind of survey, and he was very confident that people like Pepsi to Coca-Cola because of the taste of Pepsi. But he was not able to compete with Coca-Cola because Coca-Cola was the big company. Now, do you think Coca-Cola will remain big if they don't listen what is going on, why people like Pepsi? So one day definitely Pepsi will take over Coca-Cola, or not take over, but will beat the Coca-Cola. And it happened at that time because Coca-Cola was not listening what Pepsi was doing. And Pepsi was doing, they were making people aware that the taste of Pepsi is better than Coca-Cola, right? How big you can be, how large you are, you need to listen what people are talking about. This is one message. So here it was a Pepsi and Coca-Cola. Second, very example, very important principles of marketing. Let me continue with this principle of marketing next for 5-10 minutes. Then we'll go for what I was did to discuss with you. And that would be something which is not my own work, but I have taken it from Harvard Business School, right? So let me continue with second point, promotion, always be talking. What is promotion basically? It's basically creating a buzzword. Buzzword means you do something So people start talking about you. So as a human being, you want that people appreciate you, people talk about you, and you become talk of the town, right? So there is a case, we call it half.com, where one company, the company was very small like Pepsi. The big company was eBay. I hope you know the eBay. Let me see if you know the eBay in your chat box, everybody. What business eBay is in? Anyone? Any idea? Okay, thank you, Divyanshi. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So Divyanshi Gupta has already mentioned it was an e-commerce. Basically, they started buying and selling books, and then they enter into e-commerce, and eBay had become very big, very, very big organization. So in 2000s, half.com was very, very small, and half.com was the biggest competitor of eBay, because in the sense that in future half.com will beat this eBay company. That's why it was a big, I'm saying that this was going to be tough, you know, kind of war between these two companies. So half.com, they wanted to promote their business, but they don't know how to go about it. So you need to create such kind of buzz. So what they did in USA, in California, they decided to change the name of a town. Can you do like this? Can you change the name of a town in India or a name of a village in India? It's not an easy job. You need to take permission from local administration and they're from the top people from that town, and it's not be a very easy job. But half.com had taken this initiative and they had become buzz of the town. So you need to create a buzz where people are talking about you. Can you think of any product nowadays people have been talking about? Put in your chat box, or you can unmute your mic if you wish. Anyone? Go ahead, everybody. Let me see your reflection. Any product which you feel that has become buzz of the town, people talk about that product. People talk about that brand. Yeah. Anyone? iPhone. Great. Thanks, Sohar Batra. iPhone is a product, I don't know, because of price, because of technology, because of the kind of proposition they have offered with that product. Because of that, iPhone has. Thank you, Sohar Batra. Thank you very much. Any other product, anyone? Let me see your reflection. Go ahead, everybody. Just think, because I mean, you all are in commerce, you all are in business, you are part of marketing. As a buyer, you understand everything, but you need to reflect on that, why these products, why CCD, why Cadbury, why iPhone, and why, okay, let me see, Deepika say it's Apple's products, okay, we already had discussed, any other, okay, Telsa, very good, thank you, Akansha, thank you very much, and then Khushbu Starbucks, okay, let me tell you Khushbu one story, what happened, Starbucks, when they came here, in Niti Bagh, it's in Hoj Khas, there was a company called Sardar Baksh, and the monogram of Sardar Baksh coffee house was like Starbucks monogram. So Starbucks sent a legal notice to Sardar Baksh that your monogram is look like Starbucks coffee, so you need to change it, otherwise you need to pay penalty. So what happened, Sardar Baksh in Niti Bagh in Hoj Khas, the taste was so good, and lot of people, those who live in Hoj Khas, most of them are from a profession called advocates. I mean, they were advocate actually. So they decided to fight with Starbucks on this issue, right? So this is something that you become a buzz of the town. So Sardar Baksh coffee house had become a, you know, buzz of the town, and you wouldn't believe, within 1 month, they received an application from people. They want to open the chain. They wanted to open the store of, or the chain of Sardar Baksh. So in my own college, if you see, come to Karodimal College, behind my college, there is a market called Kamlanagar. There also, I know, I remember last time when I visited, I saw Sardar Baksh. So right now, within 2 years, you can think 30 stores of Sardar Baksh has been opened because of this tussle between Star Bakh and Sardar Baksh. So now Sardar Baksh, yeah, it was a good coffee, good taste, different taste, people used to like it, but they were not so famous. So sometime you never know what will make you famous, what will make you you know, budge of the town, but you need to find out something so that you can become budge of the town. Okay, so Pooja Arya says Samsung because of quality, and Khushbu mentioned Starbucks. Thank you. Why Starbucks, Khushbu? Can you unmute and tell me? Don't hesitate, this is the platform where you can speak. Okay, so Hark Batra says Zomato. Thank you very much. Khushbu, can you unmute your mic and tell me why Starbucks? Don't hesitate. Okay, so Hark Batra, why Zomato? Please unmute your mic and tell me why Zomato. Because of, okay. Is it because of IPO or because of the kind of services they have been offering? Okay, great. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay. Thank you very much. So here you can see we have been talking about principle, and then let me take 2 or 3 more minutes and then we will move to another topic, which is actually redefining our 4 P's. So here, activation, always execute purposefully. You should have some purpose. Just think of that, okay, I want to promote this particular product. I want to make this product, I want to take this product up to this level. The reason is this, that people would like this product. People would like to have this product. And nowadays, because of this, these things has emerged. Now just think of 3 or 4 needs has occurred because of COVID-19. And if you are able to execute that need with some purpose, and the purpose here would be because of COVID-19, this kind of new need has occurred, new problem has occurred, new issue has emerged. So to serve that purpose, to solve that problem, you need to come out with some kind of activation and you will have some purpose. So let me see. Can you think of at least 2 issues or solution which has emerged because of COVID-19? And very different companies, they become active and they execute a particular purpose. So the purpose was to provide some kind of relief during COVID-19, because we were all in lockdown and we were not able to access different kind of services. But a lot of company, they become active and they had some purpose and they executed that purpose. Let me tell you one example. One of my student, they have been making special packaging material, and they used to make special kind of cardboard. And with that cardboard, they used to make packaging board, packaging, stuff kind of things. So during COVID-19, 2 years back, so I call him that, what are you doing? So he said, sir, we have designed a bed for COVID-19 patient. I said, what is that? He said that whenever a COVID-19 patient come to hospital, they need place to take rest, so they need bed, and the person may be there on bed for next 15-20 days, maybe 30 days. Now next patient don't want to use the same bed because already that bed has been used by someone who was suffering from COVID-19. So I said, yeah, you are right. People don't want to use the same bed, right? So he said that we have developed a special kind of cardboard and we are trying to make a bed for COVID-19 patient, and that bed would be, because it is made of cardboard, we can reuse it, recycle it, right? And anyone can use it for 20 to 30 days, and then we will take it and we'll recycle it and we'll make another kind of product. And it's so cheap, it cost hardly 500 rupees. So here I said, are you minting money? He said, no, my purpose is not having some money. But my purpose is, because my company is already a big company, there's no dearth of opportunity, there's no dearth of money, there's no dearth of sale, everything is okay. So because I'm part of my country, so I felt that I should do something to my country, because I have been into this business. So I thought I should come out some kind of solution so that I can serve people, those who are suffering from COVID-19. So then he took permission at that time from government in Uttar Pradesh, and then he start making that bed. And now lot of hospital, they order this bed, because once you can use it for 20-25 days, 30 days for one patient, and then you can return that bed, cardboard bed, and then they recycle it and use it for their packaging material purpose. So to see this is what, these are some examples. Why I'm quoting this example, because now the concept of marketing has little bit changed in last 5-10 years, and people are not talking about the core product of or not talking about the core marketing, but they are talking or redefining marketing basically. So here you see the things has changed. And here you see, you need to be always be agile, you need to be always flexible, and you need to communicate. That's very, very important. So here you can see, you need to be a listener, you need to talk about your purpose, you should have some purpose, and you need to be a bit flexible, because whatever challenge, whatever things come, things are so dynamic. Today you like this, tomorrow you like this. You know, technology has made everything, every product, so much, you know, what you call, so much changes are occurring because of technology, I must say. So we need to be agile, we need to be flexible, in the sense that we need to understand that, okay, today you need this, tomorrow you would be needed something else. So, but you need to listen that again and again, talk about that, and create another product, be active, create some purpose, and continue with your marketing. So it was little bit about principle of marketing. Now, on the basis of all this discussion, now question arises: don't you think price, promotion, product, place, we need to redefine them? Let me see. Say yes or no in your chat box, everybody. Go ahead, everybody. Do you think on the basis of this discussion, we need to redefine our 4 P's, that was price, promotion, place? Go ahead, everybody. Let me see your reflection in your chat box. Go ahead. Yes, sir. Thank you, everybody. Rajini, Pooja, Deepika. Great. Go ahead, everybody. Everybody needs to reply, then we'll move further. Sumi, see, yes. Thank you. Daksh, thank you very much. Go ahead, everybody. Akansha, Kushi, Divyanshi, Akansha, Gaur. Go ahead. Okay. So on the basis of this, I hope I am able to convince all of you that things has changed. We need to move away from those traditional concept of marketing, traditional concept of 4 P's, because if it was just a product, it would have been chocolate, not a kind of relationship, not a kind of happiness, which we represented in our examples, right? So let us see why we need to reframe this 4 P's. It's not me who decided to think about reframing 4 P's. My dear student, Harvard Business School, they decided to reframe 4 P's. And you wouldn't believe, it took them 5 years. It took them 5 years. And they made a survey among 5,000 managers. And finally, instead of 4 P's, they designed SAVE framework. Right? So don't make my life miserable. Don't tell anyone that Pushpendra sir had started the concept of redefining 4 P's in terms of SAVE framework. It was not me. It was by Harvard Business School. They had taken an initiative, they conducted a survey, and they wanted to discuss up to what extent we should continue with the 4 P's, or this is the right time to redefine 4 P's. So these 4 P's has been redefined in terms of S, A, V, E. And it's not in the year, it's on the basis of a research. It took them 5 years basically, and they collected information and data from 5,000 managers around the world. Right, everybody? Now, question arises why we need to redesign, reframe 4Ps into SAVE framework. So here you see, the traditional 4Ps model is narrow and outdated and is not strictly relevant in a modern business environment. Right? Why this is so? The answer already we have discussed in last 1 hour, because things has changed, things are so dynamic. I mean, we our taste, our like, our dislike has changed over the period of time. Whatever I used to like 5-10 years back, the things has changed. I like something else. Right? I want that everything should be at my doorstep. I want that nobody should disturb me. I should not go to bank. Everything should be, all transactions should be online. Right? So CRM, customer relationship management, has occurred. Now you want to buy a product from a company where you see company is reliable. Not only reliable, they got large number of review, positive review. So you want to check the review also. And what exactly, what unique purpose that company is going to solve? So is it a problem of COVID-19, immunity, or what? What purpose they're gonna serve you, right? So this is what here, this 4Ps model basically had been outdated. It's a narrow, and strictly if you see the current business, modern business environment, it's not so relevant. It may be relevant up to some extent, but fully it's not so relevant. That's why Harvard Business School has offered this SAV framework. Let us talk about this 4Ps. Now what is the problem with the 4Ps? First, they overemphasize product, technology and quality. They say that, okay, this is because of quality and this is because of technology we are offering you a unique product. Now are you really looking for technology or quality? More than that, what you are looking for? You are looking for a solution. Is this quality, is this technology going to resolve a particular problem, going to resolve or going to give you relief, going to give you happiness? And see around nowadays, whatever technology has emerged, whatever quality has emerged, is it really going to give you happiness? All physical products, all material products in your place, at your home, are they really going to give you happiness? What we are looking for? We are looking for happiness. We are looking for satisfaction. So this technology, your mobile phone, is it really giving you a tough time, making your life miserable, or it is really going to give you happiness? Let me see your reflection. The one technology which is 24 hours with you, and it's a good quality, high technology goods, iPhone or other products, Samsung products, do you feel that happiness has, you know, gone up because of this technology or quality, or it has come down? Let me see your reflection in your chat box, everybody. How do you see this technology and quality? Does it really give you some happiness, or you feel, oh my God, 24 hours I am attached with my mobile phone, I am fed up with that. Okay, calm down. Okay, great, Aniket. Thank you, Jasveer Singh. Thank you very much. So this is what lot of, because, and here as a human being, what we are looking for? We are looking for simple solution, right? That will serve your purpose. So are you looking for you want to have some solution that is communication, because we all are social animal. What you are looking for? A small phone so that you can chat, you can communicate, and that cost you 1 lakh rupees. Just think of technology, just think of quality. Quality would be very high, the things would be very high, right? Technology would be the latest technology, but don't you think it has become headache? Right? It is, you are supposed to compromise with your quality of life. So it has become an integral part of our life, but somewhere they have, you know, made your life miserable, unfortunately. So here, the P, the product, they talk about quality, they talk about technology, but they are not talking about the kind of solution they are offering. Then second, understate the necessity of explaining the value of the product and why customer need it. And you wouldn't believe it. Just check your home. You will see a lot of product which actually you don't need. And you bought these products because you felt that, okay, because it should be here in my home, in my house, because I have this kind of prestige, I have this kind of respect in the society. But personally, you don't need this product. For example, whenever you visit to South India, you will not see couch, right? I mean, you don't see sofa set, you will not see a big bed. They live a very, very simple life. And I mean, so here in the, especially in North, I'm not, you know, comparing anything, but here you will see, you go to every home, you will see a lot of stuff. Sometimes you don't need it, you buy it just for one purpose, and you buy because I don't know for what purpose you are buying, right? And there have been a lot of company, they have been, you know, provoking you, they have been forcing you, they've been motivating you to buy different products because their purpose is just to sell. You have some necessity or you don't have any necessity, but these companies are selling these goods and services. And here you see, distracts businesses from promoting themselves as important source of information and problem solving. So these businesses, basically, they are not there to solve our problem or to give the information what you are looking for. So this is something which we call, I'm sorry, I'm going a bit fast now because we have very limited time. I have to discuss a bit more. Is it okay, everybody, if I continue, I mean, little bit more? So first, you can see, first, S means solution. A solution-focused approach is needed when it comes to marketing products. Very simple thing, very simple. You need a solution to a problem. You need a solution to a particular issue. You need a solution for a particular need. You don't need a solution which cost you 1 lakh rupees, right? Which is of high quality, which is of very sensitive quality. You need a solution, simple solution, right? I remember, just think of 30 years back when refrigerator was not accessible because of cost. Each and every home, they were not able to access refrigerator. So how they used to get cold water, especially summer, during summer? Very simple solution we used to have. Simply, you want to make curd. So do you really need, now Samsung has said that if you want to have very special kind of curd, you need Samsung refrigerator, which will cost you 60,000 rupees. So do you really need that Samsung refrigerator for making curd? Or you have some pot made of some special metal or maybe a scent, right? So this is what we need to focus on, some kind of solution. And here, a solution focus approach is needed when it comes to marketing products. So when you market products, actually what you need to do, you need to give some kind of solution. So today, customer have far more input, the business, customer relationship, which necessitate a new framework that better reflect what the customer want and cares about. So today, we know the company know everything about us. So here, what we need to do, we understand what is customer wants, what they care about. So we need to give some kind of simple solution, which would really, you know, make their life happy, more beautiful, more healthy, rather than miserable. So this is solution. Then comes to, so product means solution. Then place means access. Price means value. Promotion means education, to educate the customer, right? So I'm talking about reframing the four P's. So first P's, we have redefined product in terms of solution. Now talk about, so we continue with the solution. Solution rather than product. Researchers argue that businesses tend to get caught up in the feature and functions of their product, when all customer really want to know is how the product solve their problem. Very simple thing, very simple thing, right? You need a solution with a simple product. And but when you think of a product, they say they have this kind of feature. And I know, just think of your mobile phone. Have you ever tried to use all the features of your mobile phone except 4 or 5, and it has got 20 features? So you are paying for extra 15 features which you are not able to use at all in your mobile phone, right? So this is what the product concept, they say that these features we have, that's why the cost is so high. And think of an automobile, think of a four-wheeler car. Now you buy a car, so many features are there and you don't know how to use it, and you are not supposed to use it because there is no use of that feature. But the car of cost has gone up because of those features. So what we are looking for? We are looking for a solution. We want to commute from one place to another place. First would be safety. Second would be, it should be economical, right? Or maybe good look. Then save advocate marketing a product based on how it meet customer needs rather than emphasize its features. So this is about solution. First, very important and simple concept. Let me move to second one. Who is the good doctor, do you know? Who knows his medicine or who knows his patient? Let me see your reflection. Who you think would be a good doctor? Who knows his patient well or who knows his medicine well? Who knows patients well? Thank you, Rajni. Okay, go ahead everybody. Let me see. Arya Mishra say patient, Deepika say patient. Okay, who knows his patients? Okay, great. Pooja Arya has mentioned. Go ahead everybody. I can see you all are with me. Okay, great. So here we are talking about solution. We are talking not about the product. I hope with this one example. And I'm not quoting here example of teacher and student. Who is good teacher, who knows, who has got good knowledge, or who knows student better than anyone else. So we continue with next. Access. Access means place. Place, you know, distribution channel. So in access, here when we redefine place in terms of access, here the focus is on how accessible your company is to your target customer. Unfortunately, because of online, because of internet, whenever you want to avail services, whenever you want to avail online services, you stuck somewhere. Now you are in problem. You have to call customer care. And when you call customer care, you feel that it's a biggest headache. You can't, you know, access to the company. So what company should do? So is it they should provide you product through a particular channel, or they remain there 24 hours with you? If you find any problem, if you are in any trouble, you can access them at any time, right? I remember recently I bought some product, but it was very small product, and it cost me, it was basically I wanted some plant for my drawing room. So I thought, what should I do? So I watched one video on YouTube, and that YouTube video has mentioned one brand. So I ordered through that brand and through that website, and the brand was, I forgot the brand, but the kind of services they offer, can you believe it? Immediately when I order it, I got a message that your order has been received and we will update you every day. Where is your product? So that plants were coming from Pune. So next day they say that your plant has been packed and it is moving from nursery to airport. So I got a message. Then second day they say that from airport Pune it has come to Delhi. Now it's in Delhi airport. And they were showing that picture also, that from nursery to this place, this place to this place, this place to this place, and this much time it is taking, these many days it is taking, everything. I was connected 24 hours with that company. And when they wanted to come to my home, they say that now our customer is, you know, 5 hours away from your home. Maybe tomorrow early morning he will come at your doorstep at 7 o'clock. So now I know where is my product. I know everything about that. And then after delivering a product, they say that we are here for next 30 days with you. If you find any problem, any issue with the plant, you can reply to us through this WhatsApp group. Similarly, HDFC, when you have any trouble with the HDFC bank credit card, you're not supposed to call them for any service. They offer you a kind of WhatsApp link, and the whole menu, whatever you want to access, whatever services you want, is available on your on that menu through your WhatsApp. So that is what you feel, because now physically you're not in touch with your buyer, not in touch with your customer or a company. So you need to access them. How are you going to access? That would be through the some process, and that would be accessibility to a particular goods or services, and that company who is offering that solution to you, so that you can understand that what who is offering, what they are offering, and what would be the process they are being adopted. So the exact location where someone can purchase your product is not so important, and I know that you understand this concept now. From where they supply, that's not important. This approach considers the customer journey from where they first hear of your company to actually making the purchase, right? So this is very important. I heard about that plant, I heard about that company, and then I order. And experience was such kind of experience that I never ever had in my life. I was so happy that plant is okay. But more than that, they had given me a such kind of experience that they were with me. Now your product is here. This has been packed, this has been delivered, this is at airport, every pin, you know, every step information, they were in touch with me. So here you can see, customer want to see that businesses care about customer feedback. So what is important? They say that, could you give us feedback? I said, it was a wonderful experience. So, and they say that if you want some advice, if you can give some advice, how we can improve our services. So I felt that I'm not only a customer, I'm an advisor to that company, right? So this is something that you become accessible. Now, very, very important thing you can see. For us, when you think of a product in terms of price, we say it's a value for money. Are we really talking about value for money, or you are looking for something else? Here you can see customers are drawn to value more than to price. So this means that entrepreneurs need to build a strong case for showing customer why their products offer superior value to competitions, rather than focusing on the actual price tag. So now people like you all are very, very young students. I believe people, those who are in my generation, we all were price sensitive. But people in your generation, you're not so price sensitive. You want product at any cost. Price is not so important. And you're looking for what? You're looking for style. You're looking for design. You're looking for color. You're looking for value, actually, what they are offering. Maybe in terms of packaging, maybe in terms of delivery, maybe quick delivery, that within 24 hours, product would be available at your doorstep. Or the look of the product, design of the product, color of the product. So you don't want to compromise with the quality, shape, color, design of the product. So for you, price is not important. But when you pay price, you check, is it really worthy? Right? You check the value, value in the sense that packaging of that product. What additional value they are offering to you? What kind of services they would be offering to you? Or post-purchase experience, what kind of experience they will give you, right? So this is all value over price. price. So not only stick to price in terms of price or cost, but it would be more than that. And I'm not going to reflect on one this example of Kia Sarkar. Kia Sarkar, one lady who was working in MNC in Mumbai, and she was very happy whenever she used to go to Bhaji market. Bhaji means Sabji Manji market. She used to buy fresh fruits, bright colored fruits and vegetable, and she was very happy. One fine day she got a chance to visit nearby village, and when she visited, she saw that lot of farmers, they are carrying spray can on their back, and that spray is used to protect the cauliflowers and other fruits and vegetables. So she asked farmers, what is this? So they say that we are using chemical on what you call vegetable and fruits to protect them, and it will grow them fast, and it will, you know, make them, it will give them good color to all, and that's why all vegetable and fruits will look, will have kind of shining. So she was very upset that, oh my god. And she saw that they have a special sachet of chemical which they put on a each and every cauliflower. So whatever cauliflower, whatever vegetable fruits you buy and get it home, if they are colorful, very shining, very bright, just think of that they all are, you know, chemical have been used on that. So it's not a chemical free. So she was very, very upset. And what she did, she decided to grow organic products, especially fruits and vegetables. And then she saw that a lot of people, instead of using chemical, they have been using neem water. You put neem in a water, and that will become some kind of you know, chemical, and you can, that will protect your fruits and vegetables. So you don't need to use chemicals which comes with a lot of harm to vegetable, fruits, and to your, finally to your health. And she starts selling it, and you wouldn't believe, lot of people, they were ready to pay premium. They want that product, fruits and vegetables, because these all were organic at any cost, right? I hope you all understand that whenever the fruits or vegetable are organic, you're ready to pay high cost. Like Tata has introduced organic dal, or other company, a lot of company now they're starting organic fruits and vegetable and other eatable products. So if these are available, you would like to buy at any cost. So that would be not a price, it would be a value which you are looking for. So what they serve, it's an organic product, it's more than a product they are serving. So here price is not important. And last very important thing, when you think of promotion, it's not a promotion. You are not selling your product with some pamphlets, with some advertisement, with some discount, with some coupon. Basically, you need to educate people. You need to educate that, yes, I remember I was watching BBC Earth. Please watch this program. And they say that lot of people, they use, they take a tablet and capsule for, it's a kind of substitute for vitamins, right? So do you really need vitamins? Or there are some, you know, drinks which detoxicate your body. So according to this research on, there was a documentary on this. So the team of doctor, they made a research that do you need some drink or do you need some capsule or tablet to detoxicate your body, or there is a need to detoxicate your body. And a lot of people, they are buy a lot of products, a lot of drink to detoxicate your, their body. So they made a research, it was a team of doctors from Britain, and they made a representation, they made a presentation. They say that you don't need any product, any liquid, anything to detoxicate your body. Body has got such kind of, you know, process, body has got such kind of elements or ingredients, they then it itself detoxicate, right? So we have our own system, right? We have our own system, but this big company, those who provide this solution, those who make this solution, those who make this kind of liquid or soft drink or this kind of product, they have this marketing strategy that they put you in a framework where you feel that or you are afraid of something, you are scared of something, that if you don't buy, if you don't use this detoxicate product, then you would be in trouble, you will not have good health. So who is going to tell you? This big company, MNCs. So they educate in some other manner which they should not. So what is the purpose of your organization? What is the purpose of your promotion? It should be rightly, you should educate, ethically you should educate to your customer that whatever you buy, tablet, capsule or any what you call drink to detoxicate your body, you actually don't need this. So we need to educate customer that okay, you don't need it because your body is having such kind of element, having such kind of parts that it can detoxicate itself. So you don't need to buy it. You need to use excess of these solutions. So here this is a one example. So this is what, instead of promotion, you need to educate. This helps to build a relationship of familiarity, and so ultimately it gives you trust. Now you start believing in that. Yes, you don't need anything to detoxicate your body because body itself has such kind of element, has got such kind of process that it can detoxicate itself. If you start eating something, then automatic system or body will stop working and then you would be in problem. So I have so many examples which I can give, like Eddie Wood is a one example which has become buzz of the town in Delhi University. Doobie-Doo has one organization. So Eddie Wood is an organization, whenever you want to advertise your products, your goods or services through Facebook or YouTube, it cost you a lot, right? It cost you a lot. So Eddie Wood, what they did, they said that we will provide you similar kind of services at 90% less cost. But our platform would be different. We will have our own platform instead of Facebook. So we will have a registered customer. We will have target customer. We will send your message. We will develop your pamphlet or your promotion message. Everything will develop and we'll send it to the target customer. At what cost? At 90% less cost. So what do you need to do in marketing? So here we have discussed something which is very, very important. I'm not going to discuss all the examples. Here you see furnitureonrent.com, which I already told you. So last very, very important thing I hope I should discuss with you, all of you. There is a company called ninjacart.com, one boy who passed out from IIT Kanpur. And he came back, so let me see if I have some more time to discuss this. Sir, can I discuss this example? Take 5-10 minutes more?
Yes.
Thank you. So, what happened, this is what it actually redefining the whole marketing system. The whole 7 P's and 4 P's. This is a very excellent example. A boy from IIT Kanpur, and he came back to his hometown, Bangalore. And he saw that because he had a time to join an organization, it was approaching a 6-month time he had. So what to do when you are at home? So your mother will ask you to go to market and buy some products, some stuff, maybe vegetable and fruits. So his mother told him that don't sleep, go to market and bring some fruits and vegetable. He brought fruits and vegetable and it was not so fresh and it was costly too. So his mother was not so happy. So he decided to understand the whole chain. So what he did, when you think of vegetable and fruits, it comes from retail shop, it comes from mother dairy, it comes from Reliance shops, right? But from where they procure from Ajarpur Mandi, right? When you think of fruits and vegetable, we have Mandi, like Gajipur Mandi, Ajarpur Mandi. Similarly, in Bangalore, they had a mandi. So he visited at mandi, and you wouldn't believe the business take place during night time in mandi, sabji mandi. Why night time? Because trucks are allowed to enter into city after 10 p.m. So they enter into mandi or Delhi or main metropolitan city or big city after 10 o'clock. So the whole business take place in Monday during night time. So he decided to understand the whole business. So he used to come every night to Sabji Mandi in Bangalore, just wanted to understand how the business take place. So he saw that always it takes around 16 to 20 hours to procure fruits and vegetables from farmers to end consumer, that is the retailer or the customer. So he saw this and wanted to redefine the whole chain. Believe me, supply chain is the most typical kind of business, more difficult type of business, supply chain management. So he took this initiative. What he did, he decided to reduce this time from 20 to 8 hours. How come? It was not an easy job. So what he did, he talked to farmers that we'll come to you at 8 o'clock in the evening, we'll collect everything from you and we'll bring at collection center in the evening at 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock, and from 11 o'clock we will start distributing to the retailer. So early morning 4 o'clock to 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock, the produce which we collected in the evening 8 o'clock will come here 6-7 o'clock to retailer. When customer come at 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock or 6 o'clock in the morning at the shop, he will get fresh fruits and vegetables. So this one boy had brought this kind of magic in supply chain, and now this has become a big company in Bangalore, and they have been into a supply chain management of fruits and vegetables. And what they did actually, they redefined the whole concept of marketing. Because what was marketing there? Who was powerful? The retailer. Now retailer say that I got this fresh fruits and vegetable because of Ninja Cart, right? Ninja Cart understand what you need. We provide you solution. Solution is this, that we provide you good quality fruits and vegetable, but very fresh fruits and vegetable at reasonable price. So you are the happiest person because you are getting all fruits and vegetables which comes from produce from farmers within 8 hours. Because fruits and vegetables is a kind of perishable products, right? So what you're looking for? You're looking for a solution. So these kind of example, just think of these kind of example where I have mentioned Edible, D-Wood, DUVDU. These all are from our own institution, Clodimal College. And they are actually helping us to redefine market in terms of education, in terms of Ninja Cart, right? So let me tell you one very important thing, what Mahatma Gandhi has mentioned, what has said. I'm not against of mass production, but I want production by masses. So here I urge all of you, I request all of you, just think of solution. Just think of solution, what you can provide, what you can think of, what solution you can offer, right? Just find out something which can be a kind of opportunity, but it should be some kind of issue, it should be a kind of problem. And convert into a commercial product, commercial solution, and it should be a very unique kind of solution. Serve that, start serving that solution, and then you will see actually you are supporting redefining 4 P's, 7 P's, and the whole concept of marketing. Right, everybody? So what should I do? Let me, I have this kind of presentation.